Families of Nicaraguan political prisoners are calling for the release of their loved ones, many of whom have been participating in a hunger strike from behind bars for more than 3 weeks. They're trying to call attention to alleged human rights abuses by Nicaraguan security forces and paramilitary groups. Scarlett Narvaez says her husband Ernesto is among the prisoners participating in the hunger strike. She says her husband and several others have sewn their lips shut as part of their protest.
They made the decision to do a hunger strike, partly as a way to demand their freedom, because they suffer from constant physical and psychological mistreatment.
Nicaragua's president, Daniel Ortega, has denied allegations of torture, adding that human rights observers are welcome to visit the prisons.
The doors are open for you to visit. They say they're being tortured, that they're dying, that they've sewn their lips shut. I'd like to see their lips sewn. They fabricate such things to create a negative image of Nicaragua.
In response, a team of human rights observers traveled to El Chipote prison in Managua, but were intercepted by security forces who denied them access.
It's a lie that we've been able to prove. The speech from President Daniel Ortega was a lie from head to toe, where he said the jails were open to human rights institutions like ours.
On October 21st, the OAS passed a resolution calling for electoral reforms in Nicaragua and urging the state to respect human rights. Julio Montenegro, a defense attorney representing the families of several prisoners, says many were hoping the OAS resolution would include a timeline for the release of political prisoners.
We were expecting the liberation of political prisoners as a demand, but that's the way things go. Even the political prisoners say they feel they've become a sort of bargaining chip.
Since the start of the political crisis in 2018, the Nicaraguan government has been accused of a long list of human rights violations, including locking up government critics and silencing journalists. Manuel Rapalo, Al Jazeera.